Massive Metro.
The Takeover with Tembi Siebe.
Would you say that the space for jewelers, would you say that it's doing well? People are interested and they are buying. How is the market out there?
The market is really great. I mean, it's amazing. The reception I've had has really been great. I think there's definitely women love buying. They're impulsive and they love beautiful things. Yeah. I think the main thing is that it's just about setting yourself apart. And that's how you're able to captivate the market. And then within the market, knowing what you stand for. So being authentic in terms of, are you using the right kind of materials? Are you making sure that your clients are catered for? For instance, I use brass with my earring hooks and my pins and things like that, just to make sure that people are not going to react. So it's all about that.
Oh, I see. So it's also important, hygienic and the material that you use. Yes. What sets you apart from the rest?
I would say that my design style sets me apart. The way that I layer the different materials.
Yeah.
I often get people saying that they haven't seen something like this before. So I think it's having the background that I have and merging all those different elements together sets me apart, because I have that design style that's different.
Well, I can see that it's, you are gifted naturally. But
Thank you.
Also go for a certain, maybe a training somewhere? Did you sort of try to polish what God has already blessed you with, which is this talent of putting together jewelry?
So
would you say that training is important?
Training, I think, is definitely a great thing, because it allows you to actually be able to do more and push your boundaries more. At the moment, I think most of the stuff I did was actually just by learning, you know, buying different tools, going home and seeing how to use them. Sometimes I'd even go on YouTube and see how to actually use these different elements and how I can create shapes or things that I'm trying to create.
Right.
But I definitely, I mean, I want to actually get into a program. At the moment, it's all about, you know, setting aside that time, because it's obviously very time intensive.
Wow, that's amazing. You know what? We had an interview with a photographer yesterday, and he says he draws inspiration from, be it maybe the sun or the weather or the sands, depending on how the picture looks outside, which is a natural picture. Where do you draw your inspiration from? How do you come up with the sketch? How do you come up with the fact that you want to do your earring, the one that you're wearing now? It's half moon, and at the same time, it's the sun and all of that. What do you look for? How do you draw inspiration? Where do you draw it from?
A lot of the shapes that I've created are from things which I guess I'm seeing in everyday life.
Yes.
So, like you're saying, there's actually a lot of my pieces are also based on elements. So I do have things like sundial studs and sunset earrings. And some of them are, you know, especially with my I have a lot of triangular shaped items. When I was doing some of those, it had to do with just goal setting and direction. So it was about where you headed. So sometimes sometimes I work on different collections. So each collection will have its own inspiration. Like my next collection is going to be about equilibrium and balance. So I'm going to be playing a lot with proportions.
That's amazing.
Because at the, like, growing a business as you go, you start to shift and learn that whilst you're expanding, you really have to get your balance. And so that's what meant. So they all vary.
Only on Massive Metro.